Hi guys, welcome to my channel. This is Sharon Oyella, and I've actually been away from this channel for a few years. I haven't done any crocheting or videos in a really long time. I've been on my other channel, which is linked in the pinned comment below. I've been building for gnomes and things like that, but I haven't done crochet in a really long time, and I needed to ease my way back in. So I thought of this little pillow here. My friend sent me a couple of years ago. She's here on YouTube. I'll put her link in the pinned comment below. But she sent this to me. I think it's absolutely adorable. And I decided to recreate it in crochet. That way I can teach some basics in crochet and also get myself back into crocheting and making videos again, because it has been so very, very long. And I'm feeling a little bit nervous. I'm also very excited, but I am nervous about coming back to a world that I've left so long ago. So let's get started, guys, and get over this little hump. I'm using a 4mm crochet hook and Red Heart Comfort Yarn. It's a worsted weight yarn. Similar to this yarn is Erin, and also Karen 1 pound yarn. You want to have a heavier weight yarn when you're beginning in crochet. It's just a little bit easier. And you're going to be using two different colors. You want to make sure that you're using the same weight yarn for both colors. Otherwise, you'll have two different size pieces. And we have to make two pieces, and we'll be crocheting them together. I'm also using a blunt end yarn needle. This is a size 13, I believe. You don't have to be exact. You just want something that you can weave in the yarn ends with. We're also going to be doing some sewing, like regular sewing. And for that, I'm just using a regular sewing needle. It's a bit on the large side. So we're going to be using some felt to decorate the front of our cushion and some corresponding thread colors for those felt pieces, some scissors, of course, and some embroidery thread. I'm using two different greens and a brown. And I almost forgot, you also need a small amount of stuffing. All right, guys, before we get started, let's just take a look at this cushion. We have two colors, okay? So we have the front piece, which is made of white yarn, and then we have the back piece, which is made of any color that you want to choose, okay? So in this pattern, I choose white for the front, and then any color you want for the back. So the pattern is the exact same for the front piece and the back piece, except for how we finish off. And I will walk you through that in this pattern. So I'm going to take you through every row in the pattern itself. And I'm going to be doing using this beige color here because the stitches show up better on film. And you actually don't need a written pattern to follow along the video. I'm going to walk you through every single row. I'm not going to leave you at all on your own, except for when I explain how to do a row. And then you can pause the video and then hit play again once you've caught up. So yeah, I'll take you through everything. We're going to be doing the magic ring to start with, and then single crochets. There's no decreasing in this pattern. It's very beginner friendly. We'll learn how to slip stitch and finish off, and I'll show you how to assemble everything, of course. And in the pinned comment below, you're going to find detailed timestamps, so you can skip over whatever you don't need and also go back to what you do need to see again. We are going to start with the magic ring. So this is row one. We're going to make a magic ring with 6 single crochets. Let's get started. We're going to make a magic ring with 6 single crochets. What I'm pointing to, I'm going to refer to as the starting yarn tail. And the yarn closest to the yarn ball is our working yarn. We're going to pull the starting yarn tail over our hand and wrap it around these two fingers twice. Now hold the starting yarn tail between your pinky and your thumb, then hold the working yarn between your pinky and your thumb. Now insert your hook through those two loops on your fingers, and then pull the working yarn underneath those two loops. Now you have a loop on your hook, pull the working yarn through that loop on your hook, and you've just made a slip knot. Now you can pull that off of your fingers and get ready to crochet on. Now we're ready to make our single crochets. We're going to put our hook through this ring every time we make one. So put your hook through, grab the working yarn, and pull it through the ring. Now you have two loops on your hook. Pull the working yarn through those two loops on your hook. And that was our first single crochet. Now repeat that through the ring, pull the working yarn through the ring. You have two loops, pull the working yarn through those two loops. And there's our second single crochet. Now for the third. Same thing, pull it through and through those two loops. And again, that's number 4. And again, number 5. And last time,
That was our sixth single crochet. I'm going to show you how to count the stitches in your ring. So pull the loop up with your crochet hook so you don't lose the stitch. The first stitch to count is underneath that big loop, and it looks like a V. And there should be six of these going down this string. That was 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now we need to close up the ring. So we're going to grab onto the slip knot that we made closest to the starting yarn tail there and hold it between our finger and our thumb. Then we're going to pull on one of these two strings closest to our finger and our thumb, pulling up. I got lucky that time, that's the right string. If it wasn't, I would just grab the other one and try that one. Pull it until the circle is closed. To get rid of that loop, now I need to pull on the starting yarn tail. I'm going to give this a bit of a wiggle to flatten it out a bit. And if there was still a gap in there, I'd just give that starting yarn tail a little bit of a tug. And now the gap is completely gone, and we have to get rid of the starting yarn tail, but never cut it free. Don't ever take scissors to your starting yarn tail. We're actually going to work over that in row two, because if you cut the starting yarn tail, you'll end up with a hole in your work. Those stitches will eventually let go. Okay, so just leave that. I'll show you how to get rid of that in row two. So we just finished row one, and we made a magic ring with six single crochets, and now we have six stitches in the row. Row two, we're going to put two single crochets in each one of those six stitches, and we're going to work over the starting yarn tail. In the end, we'll have 12 stitches in the row. So let's take a look at these stitches in the ring. So again, we're counting the V's, starting with the one underneath that big loop. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So when we're going through a stitch, the stitch itself, the V, has two loops in it. So when we put our hook through, we're going underneath both of those loops. Make sure that you go through underneath both loops. This is what it looks like on the side and the top. And for row number two, we're going to be putting two single crochets in each one of those six stitches. For this row, we're actually going to crochet over the starting yarn tail. That way, it buries the starting yarn tail and we don't have to worry about it. So starting row two, two single crochets into this first stitch, going through both loops, hold the starting yarn tail over your hook, grab the working yarn and pull it through, working yarn and pull it through those two loops, and there is a single crochet. Now we're going to go back into the same stitch we were just in and do another single crochet. Hold the starting yarn tail over the hook, grab the yarn, pull it through, grab the yarn and pull it through those two loops. And there was two single crochets into the first stitch. Going into the second stitch of the row, same thing, going underneath both loops, hold the starting yarn tail over your hook, pull the yarn through, single crochet. Going back into that same stitch we were just in, for another single crochet. Now into the third stitch, hold the starting yarn tail over the hook, grab the yarn, pull it through, grab the yarn and pull it through those two loops. Single crochet and going back into the same stitch for another one. Into the fourth stitch now. Single crochet and back into the same stitch, single crochet. Into the fifth stitch now, single crochet, back into the fifth, and single crochet. Now this will be the last one for the row, number six. Single crochet, and back in, single crochet. Now we're finished row two and we have 12 stitches around. Pull the loop up so you don't lose the stitch. Now we can cut free the starting yarn tail. Make sure you don't cut any of your working yarn.
Alright guys, I am popping in with an edit because in the next clip we're going to be using a stitch marker and I use yarn throughout the video, but it is better to have a stitch marker that can stay in place that can't be pulled out easily. So I'm just uploading a video now showing how I made these stitch markers here. I made one out of an acorn, one out of a seashell, and one out of string and a binder clip that is super easy to put together in just a couple of minutes. So if you want to see how I did that, you can look in the pinned comment below and there I'll have a link to that video. All right, let's continue on with the pattern.
Now it's time to add a stitch marker. I just use a piece of yarn of a different color and I go through the last stitch I just put in, grab that marker and pull it through, and leave it hanging like this. This is marking off the very last stitch in the row. Every time we finish a row, we'll be pulling out the marker and working into this last stitch.
Moving on to row 3, we're going to put one single crochet into the first stitch and then two single crochets into the next stitch. We're going to repeat that sequence all the way around. At the end of the row, we'll have 18 stitches. So one in the first and then two single crochets into the second. And by first stitch, I just mean the first stitch after the hook. So that's the first of the sequence. One in the first. And now two into the second stitch. So there's one single crochet and going back into the same stitch for another single crochet. Now we're going to repeat that sequence. One in the first and two into the second. So there's one single crochet into the first. And now going into the second stitch, we're going to put two single crochets. There was one, going back in, and there's two. Now we just keep repeating that sequence all the way around. One in the first, two in the second. And you can pause the video now and hit play again once you get one stitch before the marker. And welcome back. We're ready to finish off the row. We have two stitches left. One in the first, two into the second, and that's going to land on the marker. So there was our one single crochet. Now we'll pull out the marker and put in two single crochets. And that's the end of row 3. We just finished row 3, and now we have 18 stitches around. We're going to carry on to row 4. We're going to put one single crochet in the next two stitches, then two single crochets into the third stitch. At the end of that row, we should have 24 stitches. And now we can move our marker. Remember to pull out that last stitch so you don't lose it, and add that marker into the very last stitch you just put in. And carrying on with row 4, one single crochet in the next two stitches, and then two single crochets into the third stitch, and then we're going to repeat that all the way around. So one single crochet in the first, one single crochet into the second, and now two single crochets into that third stitch. And now we repeat that sequence, one in the first, one in the second, and then two single crochets into the third. I'll do one more set with you, and then I'll leave you on your own. One single crochet into the first, one single crochet into the second, and now two single crochets into that third stitch. There was one single crochet, and back in for my second single crochet. Now, my friends, we can pause the video. You can continue on without me, and we'll meet back here when there's three stitches left in the row. Welcome back. We're at the end of the row, ready to do our last sequence. One single crochet into the first, one into the second, and then two will land on that marker. There was one single crochet in the first, one in the second. Now we'll pull out the marker and put in our two single crochets. And that's the end of row 4. Now let's move our marker. And taking a look at the pattern again, we just finished row 4. We're moving on to row 5. One single crochet in the next three stitches, then two single crochets into the fourth. At the end, we'll have 30 stitches around. So we'll do the first set together. One single crochet in the first three stitches, then two single crochets into the fourth. There was one. One into the second. One single crochet into the third, and now two single crochets into that fourth stitch. Now, if you're following along, you can pause the video now. Just repeat that sequence, one single crochet in the next three stitches, two into the fourth, keep repeating all the way around, and we'll meet back here when we have four stitches left in the row. And welcome back. We're ready to finish off the row together. We're going to put one single crochet into the next three stitches. There was one into the second, one into the third, and then we'll pull out the marker and we'll put in our two single crochets. And now we can move the marker. Always pull out that last stitch so you don't lose it. Move the marker. Let's take a look at the pattern. We now have 30 stitches around. We're going to continue on with row 6. One single crochet in the next 4 stitches, then 2 single crochets into the 5th. At the end of this row, we should have 36 stitches around, and we're almost there, guys. One single crochet into the next 4 stitches, then 2 single crochets into the 5th. And then we repeat that sequence all the way around. Let's do the first set together. That was one in the first, one in the second, one single crochet into the third, one single crochet into the fourth, and now 2 single crochets into the 5th stitch. You can pause the video now and repeat that sequence all the way around. We'll meet back here at the end of the row when we have 5 stitches left. And welcome back. We have 5 stitches left in the row. We're going to put 1 single crochet into the next 4 stitches. Then 2 will end on that marker. There was 1, 1 in the second, 1 in the third, 1 in the fourth. Now we're going to pull out the marker and put in our 2 single crochets. Now we can move our marker. And before we continue on with the pattern, let's take a look at a couple of things. So when you look at this piece here, this is the right side, and this is considered the wrong side. You can see a huge difference there. That was the wrong side. This is the right side. And if you've lost your marker at any time during the pattern and you don't know how many rows you've done, you can take a look at the right side and we're going to count the rings. But always count behind your marker. Okay, so wherever that last stitch was in, you want to count from behind there. So if you count in front, you'll see that there's a little bit of a dip, so it's going to throw your row count off. So counting from behind the last stitch, there's row 1, that was the magic ring we started off with. That's row 2, row 3, row 4, row 5, and row 6. We're at the end of row 6. So we only have 2 rows left. We just finished row 6. We have 36 stitches around. Row 7 and 8 is 1 single crochet in each one of those 36 stitches for 2 rows. So I'll let you carry on with row 7 by yourself. You can pause the video and put 1 single crochet in each one of those 36 stitches. We'll meet back here at the marker. All right, welcome back. We have 1 stitch left, so we'll pull out the marker and put in our 1 single crochet and put the marker back in. And now we can continue on with the final row, 1 single crochet in each one of those 36 stitches. You can pause the video and we'll meet back here at the marker. And welcome back. We're at the very last stitch of row 8. We're going to pull out that marker, put in our single crochet, and that finishes row 8. So let's take a look at the pattern. You can see this is the front piece, okay, we're working on. So this one is where we slip stitch the next stitch and we're going to finish off and we're going to cut free from the working yarn. And you can see the piece is naturally folding up towards me, so I'm just going to flip those edges down. That's calling it turned right side. All right, so let's do that slip stitch. We're going to go through the next stitch, grab our working yarn and pull it through. Instead of yarning over, just pull the first loop through the second loop on your hook. And that was a slip stitch. Now we can finish off. We're going to cut free from our working yarn, leave a little bit of a tail there to work with. And now we're going to pull the yarn tail through that loop. And I like to bring it down a little ways before I pull it tight. Bring it down, and now you can pull tight. And there you go, we finished the front piece. You did it, it's all done. We can set that aside for now. To make the back piece, it's the same exact pattern as the front one, except for this final little bit here. So we finished the 2 rows, we do not finish off. So you don't slip stitch, you don't finish off. This is the final stitch that we just put in here for the back piece. All we're gonna do is just pull out the stitch so we don't lose it and leave it hanging. Then we can take that with the ball yarn and set that aside until we're ready to crochet the front and back piece together. All right, so the size of the mushroom cap, of course, is totally up to you. The first one I did there was a little bit smaller than the one I'm doing right now, a little bit different in size. So I've already threaded my needle, that's just red thread with a knot at the end. My first stitch, of course, just normal. And then the remaining stitches I'm doing, I think it's called the back stitch. So go up a little ways, and I'm going to go back towards the first stitch I just put in. And I think that's called a back stitch. Of course, you can do a running stitch all the way around. Just want to try to keep them as even as possible to give you a neat looking, tidy looking mushroom cap. And the other thing I do is I put a stitch through the yarn tail in the back. You don't want to pull the yarn tail tight because you'll alter the shape of your piece, of course, but just lay it flat and then you can just run a stitch through it, and that will just keep it out of your way as you're stitching around the rest of the cap. And I'm sewed all the way around, and then I've stopped right here because I want to add in my stem before I continue sewing that cap in. So I'm just cutting this down to size, and then I'm going to place it right underneath the cap. Push it up a little ways. I don't want the bottom of the stem any further past the last two rows there. Okay, so now I can just sew across, sewing the stem in at the same time. And again, I'm doing the back stitch across all the way to the other end. And now I can just knot it off back here. So just wrapping it through before pulling all the way through, go through that loop, and now pull it tight. Now I can cut free the excess thread. All right, so now I'm going to sew the stem in, and this one was a little bit crooked, so I had to kind of push it underneath there before I put my first stitch in. And again, I'm going to be doing a back stitch all the way around. So I just started up here in the corner, and I'm going to go down towards the bottom of the stem from here. There, that first piece was in. It was just a little bit crooked. Okay, and now starting my back stitches. And I went all the way around. And now I'm done. I can, before I knot it off, I'm going to add in my spots. And my spots, all I did was just bring up the thread, and I'm just going to wrap the thread around in one spot here, three or four times till I have a little spot. And then when I'm done, I'm going to carry the needle underneath the felt over to where I want to put the next spot. I'm sure there's fancy stitches that you could do here to make these spots a little bit different looking. You could probably also sew in some beads if you wanted to. I just did your regular spots. And of course you could do the felt as well. And those were super easy. Just cut out some circles and do a couple of stitches around to hold them in place. And now I'm going to be adding in the granary. And again, guys, there are, you know, special stitches for embroidery, and I don't hardly know any of them. So I'm just going to wing my way along. And I chose dark green and light green to accent. Okay, so I just start here at the bottom. Doesn't really matter where you start. And I'm going to bring it up and make a triangle shape. And then I just fill in the triangle. So once I got that in there, and I can go through the bottom center and fill in that little space. And I'm just doing blades of grass, and I go over the mushroom stem. And again, this is very beginner type stitches, because I am not anyone to be teaching embroidery at all. But just throwing in some blades here and there. And now I'm going to do a long one, kind of trying to replicate what my wonderful friend made me there. But I failed a little bit, I think. This is very simple stitches here, going back and forth to give some leaves along the stem here. Put some longer ones in and some shorter ones. And my thread is getting short, so I'm just going to knot it off and cut free. And now I'll go put a longer one on this side. I would love to learn how to do embroidery stitches a lot neater, and there's some really fancy stitches that you can do. I just haven't taken the time to learn them, but one day maybe I will. But once you get all the thread in there and you do, you know, like take a look at what I'm doing here. It doesn't look half bad when I'm all done. It kind of looks decorative. So don't be worried about messing it up. Okay, so I wanted to put some that look like they're coming from behind the stem, so I just go up a little ways, and just underneath that edge, putting in a couple of blades here. It looks like they're coming up from behind the stem. And now I do on the other side as well. And that gave a pretty cool effect. So now I can knot this off. And I'm going to bring in some lighter green to accent the darker green I just put in. So all this is just going over, not the entire leaf itself, but just in the middle there. You can see I just put a strand of light green, and I'll do that along the blades of grass as well. And once I was done with the light green, I did put a little bit of the brown, like my friend has here, in mine. You'll see in the next clip. But you can see there's some fancy stitches going on here. My goodness, and it looks amazing. But you can take that further if you want to. But now that I'm done mine, I'm going to crochet the two pieces together. So we have to place the wrong sides together. Remember, I showed you back at the beginning. So the wrong sides get placed together. And I want to start at the top center of the mushroom, okay, because that's where I want to end, and that's where I'm going to crochet a chain to make a loop. So we want to line these up. So the first stitch, I'm going to go through the first stitch and then the corresponding stitch of the other piece. And now I can single crochet. And then into the next stitch, same thing, corresponding with the next piece over, going through both stitches and single crochet. And I'm going to continue this all the way around. I'm going to leave a gap for stuffing. So you can pause the video and we'll meet back here when we have a few stitches left. All right, welcome back. We have about 4 or 5 stitches there. So pull out the last stitch quite a ways so you don't lose it while you're stuffing, okay? And we're just going to place some stuffing in here. Now it takes a lot more than you think it will. So I think I put about 3 or 4 handfuls in. So there's a second handful. And just keep going until you feel like it's stuffed pretty good. And I'm not finished yet either. I got it stuffed up. I'm going to put another little bit in there. Feeling around if there's any holes, any gaps that I need to fill in. Now I'm going to close it up a little bit further. So single crochet over the next couple of stitches here. I got a little bit of a gap still. So I'm going to put a little bit more stuffing in there. And you can move that stuffing around with your finger wherever you feel like there's holes or gaps inside. Yeah, that feels pretty good. Oh, nope, I want a little bit more. And that will do it. So now I can finish off here. So single crochet, I think there's 2 stitches left. I just keep going until there's no stitches left to do. And I'm just switching out to the blue one here because I wanted to make the chain a little bit more clear on screen for you. So we're going to chain the length, and the length is totally up to you, and then we're going to slip stitch it into place. So chain, you just pull the working yarn through the loop on your hook, and you keep doing that until you have the length that you want. So I believe I did about 15 chains. So that was 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. There we go. So now we take our hook and we're going to slip stitch into the next stitch next to the start of the chain. So we're just going to pull the yarn through. Instead of yarning over, just pull the first loop through the second loop. And there we go. We've slip stitched into place. Now we can break free, leave a little bit of a tail for weaving. Pull that yarn tail through that loop. Remember to pull it down a little ways first. And then pull tight. Alright, so now we have to weave in the yarn tail. So bend over the yarn tail and stick the bend through the eye of your needle. I'm going to knot it off right here before I weave it in. So I'll just pick a stitch close by before pulling it all the way through, go through that loop, and pull that tight. And now I'm going to bring my needle down into the piece, out through a stitch somewhere away from that area. Pull on it slightly and cut. And now that yarn tail will spring back in and it is hidden away. And oh my goodness, we did it, guys. You got your cushion made and I got my first video up in a long time. And I'm so honored that we could do this together. And I was able to recreate that little mushroom cushion that my friend sent me with all that love. And I was able to pass that forward to you guys. Again, I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope I was helpful in your crochet journey. And we'll definitely see you soon in the next one. Thanks so much for watching.